The Dramatist by Ken Bruen, read by Michael Deehy.
Lemsip and Greek yogurt. That was my daily fare. The lemsip for the flu I thought I had. Intermittent sniffles were more likely a throwback to the amount of coke I'd done, but I wasn't admitting that. The yogurt, because I'd read it was good for you. At least I think I had. All those live cultures destroying bacteria. Add a spoon of honey, and it's not half bad. Truth was, my stomach was a mess, and the bios eased it a bit. For 6 months, I'd been clean and sober. Though if sobriety is related to sanity, I didn't qualify. Not a drop of alcohol had crossed my lips in that time. I hadn't quit coke from any desire to clean up. My dealer got busted, and I wasn't able to find another source. I felt so bad without the booze, I figured to kick the coke too. You're on a roll, go for it. The deadly trilogy, booze, coke, and nicotine. The years I'd wasted with them. I was still smoking though. I mean, give me a break, wasn't I doing pretty damn good? Give or take another block of time, who knew? I'd maybe stop the cigs too. But the weirdest thing, the down in the crazy pool most amazing thing, I'd begun going to mass. Phew, oh. Figured that. One Sunday, gasping for a drink, sick of my own company, I'd walked into the cathedral. Sonny Malloy was singing, and wow, that was a blast. So I went again. It had got to the stage where the priest, now nodded, said, "See you next week." I liked to sit at the back, watch the sun come creeping through the stained glass windows. As the light spread across the ceiling, I felt something close to peace. The church was always crowded, and the priests were on a timeshare. So few vocations that they worked on a rota among the parishes. Drink, of course, seemed to attend every level of my life. As I watched the kaleidoscope of colour, I'd remembered one of the craftsmen who'd worked on those windows. A Dublin guy named Ray. He'd died from cirrhosis of the liver. His last days, I'd gone to visit him, and he said, "Jack, I'd rather be dead than teetotal." Got his wish. Stuart, my drug dealer, had lived by the canal. In appearance, he resembled a banker more than a drug dealer. Of course, his credo was money. We had an odd relationship. He'd explain the latest product, its effect, its side effects, and even the dangers. I seemed to amuse him. How many ex-policemen in their 50s did he supply? I was, in a way, a sort of coup for him. I found him always fascinating. He could only have been in his late 20s and was always impeccably dressed, the personification of the new Irish youth, displaying all the traits of this bright new age: smart, confident, literate, hip, mercenary. They bought into none of the shit we had been reared to. The 1916 Rising meant as much to them as the GAA. In other words, nothing. I'd been introduced to him by Kathy Bellingham, an ex-punk, ex-junkie from London who'd washed up in Galway. She hooked up with my friend Jeff, a bar owner, and they now had a baby, a Down syndrome child. When I'd been hurting, and hurting bad, I'd leaned on our friendship to get the name of a dealer. I'd scored from him many times after. Then he got busted and was doing 6 years in Mountjoy. I was living in Bailey's Hotel, run by a woman in her 80s. I'd recently been given a new room, almost a self-contained apartment. The feature I liked most was the skylight, for the glimpse of the sky. Man, I felt the endless longing that entails. If I could ever figure out what it was I'd longed for, I might be happy. Didn't seem to be about to happen any time soon. A large wardrobe contained my charity shop clothes. Till recently, I'd owned a leather coat, bought in Camden Lock. It got nicked at mass. If I see a priest wearing it, I will truly throw my hat in. Lined against the wall were my books, a hodgepodge of crime, poetry, philosophy, and miscellaneous. They gave me comfort. Some days they even acted like reassurance. I was rationing my cigarettes, 5 a day, and if there's a more subtle torture, I don't know it. As a further step towards shaky rehabilitation, I'd even changed brands. Was now buying silk cut, the shittiest level of tar. The ultimate con by the tobacco companies. These ultra
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.